All right, what's good, everybody? Stats here, back with another video. I know it's been a minute, but we're here with some it gets me every time because I want to say Utawarerumono, but it's Utawarerumono. You know what I'm saying? But we here with Utawarerumono ZAN. You feel me? Looking nice. Look at that intro screen, man. That shit's clean, which is dope because I mean I've already beat it now. It took a minute to get some stuff done, but we're here with some content, right? This is the thing. You start off with your main person, and then as you progress, every time you unlock someone, they add it to your little rock scene. And then let me just hit this real quick. You can go ahead and hit the display off. Look at that peaceful, serene sight. I mean, come on. And that intro bangs. Now the intro, you know, that was a little something different because you already know that we gonna get copyrighted for that. But that shit slapped too much to not put it in. So I had to go ahead and drop it, you know, because we looking nice out here. But you know, we out here. So let's go ahead and hit these breakdowns, and then we'll hop into some content. You know what I mean? All right. So I was given this copy courtesy of NISAmerica. Shout out to them. Appreciate it. They hit me up. They were like, hey, would you like to receive an Emperor's Edition? And I was like, bro, come on over here. All right. I dropped a video on my Twitter of me unboxing it. This is kind of clean, I'm not going to lie, you know, and I can't turn down some art books. I love me some art books. And it's also made by Tamsoft, which is the same people that's out here hitting the Senran games. Now, there are a few discrepancies. Not exactly the same. However, I'm not familiar with the source, all right? I know what it is. It's, a visual novel. They got some other games on, like, some Fire Emblem-esque type gameplay, which... After I played through the game, there's definitely some, I'm kind of interested, all right? I don't have the same, like, I just can't do long things anymore, right? I can't sit down and play a visual novel for 120 hours, all right? I ain't even finished Metal Gear Solid 5. I didn't touch The Witcher 3, even though I got the super deluxe ecosystem friendly edition. You know, I just can't be doing it. These open world, I'm trying to get through a linear game in like 14 hours and be done. Coincidentally, this game is actually extremely short. I think out of the 18 missions, there's only 13 that you actually fight in. Now, granted, there are free missions. There is multiplayer. There's some other stuff to do. But there's a few differences, all right? So as you can see off the rip, we've got a party formation, all right? We got four people that you can bring. Slightly limited during story, but then eventually you get access to everyone, all right? There are currently 12 characters in the game. We got Haku. We got Kuon. We got Rulu. Now, is it Rulu T or Rulu Tia? Rulu. Hey, you know what? Rulu Dulu hit the Wulu. You feel me? All right. Nekone. They really tested my Japanese out here with this one. Kiwi Ru. Like, what's silent? What's not? Like, okay. Right? You know, if you were breaking down Japanese, simple. Haku. Ku on. All right. Rulu T. I mean. Nekone, right? But then you got Ki. What is a Ru? Ki Ri Ru. You know what I'm saying? Atui, you know? Ogi, all right? Nosuru? Nosuru. Hello, Nosuri. All right? Ururu and Sarana. All right? You got Jashdual, which out. That's like some German shit. That ain't even Japanese, bro. We got Maroro and Ukon. All right? And we're here. All right? My man looking like a Shinsengumi leader out here. We got the old jester. Like half of them are furries too. I don't know if he got furry ears too. I think everybody might be a furry in a way, except him. I don't think he's a furry, and I'm a sneeze because, you know, wait, I'm mute it. Oh, there's another one. All right, whoo, bless me, I am back energized, ready to go. A little misty now, but you know. Oh damn. All right. Oh my lord. All right. Hey, how you doing? So we got, you know, the 12 units in the game. Now, the one thing that's a little different, which threw me off, is some things are handled differently. Like my nose. Bro. I may or may not be dying. So you got scrolls that you can equip. You know, we don't got these specialties. They got a little gacha in here. And they do different things, you know, increased duration of own stat boost. You got Dire Awakening, Desperation, Nature's Harmony, Nature's Union, Pierce Scroll. You know, you see what they do. You got the techniques for chains. The combos in this game function a little different. We have this new one, which I actually haven't seen yet. There's three for each person. He's the only one that has apparently unlocked something in my entire duration. You can enhance the skills, but I mean, out of the whole time I've been playing, he's only accumulating like three bars. We didn't make no progress, and half of the characters can't even get like past one bar, you know. And then you got some outfits here. Looks like everybody's got three different colored outfits, you know. But one thing that is different compared to the usual, can I even see it in here? All right. Oh, it was right there the whole time. So one thing that's a little different, right? Normally in most Musou games, you have access to a combo tree. And within that combo tree, you start off with like three squares and then like a triangle or two triangles. The tree that you see for each character is all they get. So in terms of combo variety, it doesn't branch off that far. And when you get your specials, they only access their specials, which are called Final Strikes in this game, at level 25. So I was trying to get all that done before I started dropping some videos on it, which somehow ended up with me getting a boss rage video out of it. But, you know, we'll save that for later. We're not just going to drop the boss before any other gameplay. You feel me? But we will get the specials eventually. I'm just going to be showing off some of the characters in here, depending on how long the videos are. But he has a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 square combo, and then you can hold in the square. But the nice thing is you have a hold button, you have your triangle button, and those end up looping. Your triangle also has a standard hold and release. And then you have the chain actions, which I'm a loser. My nose is just, oh-wee. All right, you got your jump attacks. Those are the same. It doesn't matter which one you press. Evade two times, that's just your dash. Although I feel like you can do it more than two times. I don't know why they say it like that. I don't know if it's two rapid successions. It feels the same to me. That's usually how you get around the map quick. I don't know if it's actually quicker, but you feel like you're moving quicker. And then you can switch to chain action, which I haven't had a need for because I've only had access to the one skill for the entire time. But we'll show off the chains eventually. But that's something from the regular games that they've incorporated into it. But the combo structures vary. So like she has a little bit more. She only has four, a bigger one, you know, so it's a little bit here and there. But we're just going to go ahead and hop into some gameplay, showing off the characters and their combos. And then, you know, let's get this bread. Now, it wouldn't be a good old Musou if it didn't have the traditional pan into the stage, showing off the environment, the graphics, you know what I'm saying? Although the engine, you know, I feel like they could use an update now. I feel like the texture's a little bit getting there, you know? It feels, you know, we've been on this for a hot minute. But as you can see, we got the whole squad of four, which this is where it varies. I gave her the green sprout skin. They just start balling off the rip, but we're just going to be over here minding our own business so we could get this little demonstration off. I guess I could have used a singular unit. That probably would have been optimal, but then I couldn't have showed off the... Okay, I didn't switch to get body. Bro, she is about to die. So, you know, you got the switch factor. You can also activate raids, which pops all their specials with the press of a button. Although now I am pretty sure I am limited to no longer switch. But Haku just went ahead and healed there. So this is his square combo. All right, hit him with the fan cyclone, right? And then you have the charge. That's his leap. But the good thing is with these charges, you can kind of just fluidly hop in and out. Let me just go ahead and lock on for standard procedure. So I'm gonna hit him with the full combo. He flipped behind me, no problem. Hit him with the hold combo. Come back in here, mix them up, bam, hold. And you could just repeat it endlessly, right? Then you wanna toss in a triangle. There's the jump aerial. All right, his is a rapid slash when you hold it. If you just press it, it's just one smack. All right, pretty standard. You do, of course, have his main chain attack, which you don't actually have to chain to anything. When do we click in the map? I do not know. But you just hit circle, and then bam, you just hit the QTEs. Do you really have to hit it for efficiency? It probably helps, but I mean, you don't have to time it if you're terrible at timing, so you don't got to worry about that. As you can see at the bottom, that's the meter that we use to level up the base. That's basically our meter to access the chain attacks as well as activate the final strikes. Once you have three of those fully filled, You can then use a strike attack. The strike attack can only be used once, and you gotta make sure it hits. So, you know, don't be screwing that up if you're trying to make some progress out here. But this dude's just getting mixed by the team in the corner, and I guess that's just the... Oh, that's right. Okay, so it'd be throwing me off because it says target set and target complete. There's a lot of targets in this. I don't think it's gonna show it directly in this one. But there are multiple things you can mix up and switch. Honestly, if he's gonna get his special, we might just show it off. You know, this will just be the basic demonstration, and then we'll drop the other characters later on because there are some sick characters in this, and some of them just start mixing up. Like, I'm gonna be honest, he's the main character, but some of these people be showing him up even with this special. All right, like Chick on the Bird over here, Rulu, it's just on something else. Actually, he's full while we're at it. So what you can do on top of those bars is you have something called Zeal. So once you activate it by pressing in the touchpad, we're just gonna go ahead and pop the special because why not? So, you know, we'll give you the one showcase here of what he's got. Bam, hit him with the cyclone. I mean, my man's fighting with the fan, you know, just boom, good job. I don't see anybody getting tornadoed up in it, but you know, they're there, don't worry about it. All right, everyone just got devastated. Destruction, that's the dash, like that's what I'm saying. It says two times, oh, I guess it is two times before a little break. So this is where it changes. You have main objectives and sub objectives, so you can basically defeat a certain amount of enemies and then it'll change what you have to do. So now we have to defeat 15 soldiers. All right, so it's a little bit different in terms of that, but overall, you know, it's pretty unique. The only two things that bug me is, I mean, especially coming from the Senran games, and I feel like Musou's in general, you usually have access to at least more than one skill. Sometimes they even add like a special skill on the bumpers and stuff. But I mean, as far as staying true to the material, it seems pretty consistent from what I've seen. There's definitely some stuff I want to check out from the other games once I'm done. Because some of the specials go crazy in the actual like tactical versions of the game. But I haven't even seen all the ones in that, so I can't say as far as, you know, because we're trying to get that firsthand reaction to experience them. I have seen this one and one other one from one of my favorite characters that I've come across in the game so far, and that was during the final boss battle. So this is one of the sub objectives right here. We're gonna go ahead and collect that and give them the work still. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention right there that I don't know why I didn't showcase it, but you can basically at any point hit triangle. Since there's no true combo mix-ups, you can just go ahead and toss that out and then throw triangle in there whenever for the follow-up hit. Some of them chain well, some of them don't. I mean, his is just like a step back. There are other characters with the counter, so it's situational in a sense, but there's also some mix-ups that you can do. Some flow better than others, and some just have busted triangles. I mean, his is all right. I don't know where I would rank it out of the rest of them, just because it's kind of directly in front, and it doesn't always necessarily knock back. So, I mean, as far as that, you know, it's okay. He's definitely one of the lower-end characters that I enjoy playing as, which I feel is kind of funny considering he's the main character, but there's definitely some cool things to see in here, so we're going to go ahead and switch it up. This is actually one of my favorite characters. You get her pretty early on. All right, but I love brawlers, and I mean, she just... Come on. Ooh. I haven't seen her special, so you know what? But you know why? I wasn't going to use her special right here, but now I kind of feel like I have to do this for demonstration purposes. I don't want to show off hers yet. I don't want to peep it. All right, but I just went on a tangent, and this is what I always do. I was talking about specials and stuff, and now we're just on a whole different area. Excuse me, I am dying today. So we're going to go ahead and activate her Zeal and get this, because it's funny because I feel like her special outshines his, and she's just out here riding a giant bird. She's riding a Kokopo, kind of like a Kokoro. I mean, she got her own tornado after she stomps on him three times inside the vortex, said you can't escape, and now she's riding the wind, and we're not done. Oh, look at that. She has a finishing blow. Come on now. How do you let this little girl just come out here and decimate you in terms of final strikes? All right. She's just balling too hard. And there was something funny. I can't remember. I want to say it was Rulu and Atsui that I brought on a mission. Some of the dialogue they got between them is hilarious. When I was grinding out levels to finish getting their specials last night, Rulu, that little girl on that bird, got called out for liking dirty books with some dirty boys. She's like, those are the type of dirty boys you like that you be sneaking off to read. And I was like, hold up. And she's just like, I see you sneaking away. And she's just blushing. I was like, that shit was cracking me up. She was feeling some type of way. And our bar is actually filling up hella fast now. When I was trying to get these bars filled, they were not showing up. And I was like, man, they just don't want me to use these specials. But now we got it for free. So that's Zeal activation right there. You can activate your special as many times as you want until it drains during that period. And his skills right here. Oh, wait. Actually, let me see if I can get this other chain off. Because they said he had like a beam type. I have to hit L2 to switch chains. Oh, there's the cards. Okay, here we go. Let me see his chain. Even though it's called a chain attack, you don't actually have to change it. As far as the combat being limited from the core structure, there's definitely more from a gameplay perspective that you can unlock once you start hitting up the different variations of abilities and chain attacks, because technically they do have three minor specials, which that was the second one. I completely forgot to activate that. There's just so much stuff I'm trying to talk about, but you know, that was one of them. He's the only one that has that unlocked though, so I don't have a good example of it, but that skill he has, once you see this boss video, you're gonna realize how handy that ability is. It's busted, all right, because it has the ability to auto revive your teammates if you pop it on them, as well as it heals them, and I think it gives them a little bit of damage reduction. But that insta revive comes in clutch, because you can't be letting your teammates die. That is one thing you got to do, you got to keep them alive. But I think we'll definitely go ahead and touch on that in another video, because we still got so much to cover. I didn't expect it to be like that, but you know, this has been your boy Stats, and I'm out.